Hi everyone, I'm here at the University of Sydney today. I've got one familiar face, Peter, over here.
How's it going?
And his friends Gabe and Liam.
Hey.
So everyone here is interested in, I guess, physics education. And we've got some experiments set up for you. So the first one we have here, you might hear clunking in the background, is the Van de Graaff generator. So this is, I guess, all about static charge and electricity. So, you know, you can see a bit of a discharge of electricity between these two balls. Maybe Peter or someone else has set this up. Tell me what your explanation of it is.
Well, so the basic idea is that, remember that experiment that you did, hopefully in primary school, maybe high school, where you take a plastic rod or a ruler and you rub it with a piece of cloth, a piece of felt, and then you put it next to some water or next to like a tissue or some paper or whatever, and that stream of water is slightly attracted towards that ruler. That is basically, it's separating the charges, right, to create, you know, a pull, right? So that's kind of what's happening here. There's one part of this contraption is becoming really strongly charged, and the other one isn't as strongly charged, and then it sparks across the air.
Yeah, so it's like an electric potential.
Yeah, there's a gap. As a rule of thumb, every centimeter that a spark arcs across air is between 15,000 to 30,000 volts, depending on kind of the humidity and all those kind of things. So that is
10 or 15 mix centimeter gap.
We'll take 10.
So yeah, 10. That's a lot of volts. Someone do the math, quick. I've got to go to this.
It's about 100,000, give or take. 300,000, sorry.
300,000 volts.
On a good day, this can do about a 30 centimeter spark. Today is not a good day, but we have had it do 30 centimeters before, which is
frightening.
That's what, 900 kilowatts.
So you're saying there's 300,000 volts, and there's a thing here, and there's a lot of us around, and there's this foam thing on the floor.
It's almost as if there's a nice setup here.
Yeah, I'm worried.
So the foam's there to insulate you for the probably next thing we're going to end up doing. So you can safely stand touching this and build up a lot of charge. And we should see, hopefully, some interesting things happen with parts.
Right, so this is so that I can safely stand here and touch this. What if I just touched it like now? What would happen to me?
It would hurt. Yeah, yeah. So instead of discharging into the grounding ball there, which is nicely collected throughout the ground, so it doesn't hurt.
I would be ground?
You would be ground,
yeah,
yes.
Okay, so this is to stop me being ground.
Indeed.
Okay.
Ideally.
Yeah, it's not ideal.
Shall we try it?
Okay, so there was an idea thrown around that, I don't know, you've probably seen in cartoons that when you hold one of these, your hair starts to stand on end, because I guess each strand of your hair has the same charge, and like they start to repel each other in individual hair strands. I have quite long hair, I guess, so I can try take mine out and see if it does anything on the generator. My suspicion is that if, like, my hair would be too heavy, like each individual strand. I think maybe it'll work best on fine hair. Maybe you guys can try after me, but I've never tried on one of these since I've had lunch,
really?
So I might as well. Mm-hmm.
Well, you've got to try it's science. We've got to do an experiment, right?
Yeah. Always go for my cup.
Bring back my classic Science of Long Hair series.
Yeah, that's a good 15 at the moment, so that's probably around 450
head. I actually have a wooden ruler, but it's got metal at each end, so...
Yeah, the interesting thing is that you can feel it sort of attract when the spark starts to build, and then once it discharges, it pushes back out. It's a nice little bounce effect. I'm not moving it at all.
It does have a good bounce
effect. Yeah.
That's so cool.
Okay.
Alrighty.
Anyone want to demonstrate, or I'm up first?
You're up first.
Alright,
stand on
it.
Yep. I'd maybe take your watch off. It's normally totally safe, but I'm more worried about breaking your watch than hurting you.
Okay, you're discharging it?
I'm discharging at the moment, so what you'll need to do now, lick the ground, so in order to build charge, hands on.
Hand on now?
But yeah, both hands. It's best. It's good at the moment. I'm going to now take the earth off.
Yeah.
Okay. So you should feel anything?
I don't feel anything.
Okay. But you can see the strands there.
Yeah. I think you can start to see your hair moving.
Can you give your hair a shake?
Yeah. Give it a shake.
And in particular,
oh my god, that's amazing!
How does it look?
That's so cool!
Cameraman, how is it? Are any of the longer strands like...
They are. Like, these ones are starting to push out a little bit.
Yeah,
this one out here outside of the frame.
This shouldn't hurt you.
Shouldn't.
So I might be able to convince some of it to move, if you don't mind.
All right, Cedric, can you see that?
Yeah, you can see it a little bit.
Is that a charged rod?
No, oh, so this is just perspex, so it should be completely safe.
Yeah, so it shouldn't
be. You would know otherwise, it would have hurt.
Oh my god, that's so cool.
Let's have a look at the back.
Yeah, that hair strand right there, that one's flying. I'm not flying off.
That's so amazing. Holy crap.
So, you know, this isn't the biggest Van de Graaff generator I've ever seen.
No.
But there are like a much bigger ones that exist where the charge buildup would be a lot more.
Yeah.
Yeah. Absolutely. So, I mean, I don't think I can get all my hair standing on end with this one, but maybe with a bigger one.
Seriously, so impressive.
I mean, that is still quite a significant
picture. Yeah, that's amazing.
All right.
And you can see it's clearly affecting the top here.
Yeah.
All the hair on top is
The second question I have now, which is slightly scary, is how conductive is hair? If I touch one of your strands of hair...
It's ketamine, isn't it?
Will this discharge? Will there be a spark between...
I don't think so. But if you do touch the ones at the back...
Yeah, these ones here.
Okay.
It's slightly.
Look, it's pulling towards me. Oh, that's pulling away.
So you're exchanging charge there, yeah?
Yeah.
Whoa!
You're stripping electrons out.
How do I release myself from this without getting in the
way? Toby, do you feel that?
I can feel that.
Yeah.
We have a spark.
That's amazing!
So just hands straight up, and then just step off. Don't touch anyone or anything.
Touch the ground.
Your hair should drop straight down as all the charge goes straight
into
it.
I'm going to lift my hands
straight up, and then step back.
Step back.
Step back onto the ground without touching, and your hair drops.
Hey!
Maybe bang the table a little with your hand.
Touch the table.
Before you touch metal.
Oh my god, that was awesome!
Very good.
Nice art, right? Time spark.
So yeah, you must have your shoes on.
Yeah, okay, well, mine's pretty long. How about someone with shorter hair try? Peter, you should go.
can you just try
for me? Got an AM.
Cool. Every time there's still a tiny spark.
Let's go.
Alright.
I mean, there's always going to be some...
I think,
yeah.
Toby, this might be your experience as well. Every time I do this, there's this, I know the physics, and I know that it's safe, and I trust the equipment, and I trust Liam, and I trust, the stupid amount of the years and years of education I have, but it still feels weird, and it still feels scary and slightly wrong.
Yeah, I remember this was, one of these was in my high school physics class.
Don't you feel that?
Mm.
But even now I was telling you guys, I'm scared.
Yeah, it is.
Like, it's...
Well, the other day I only had this one over here, this big bottom styrofoam, and no one would stand on it. They were too scared until I showed them it was safe. But I wasn't quite sure because it's got metal on top, how safe I would be on the charges. I had to get up there blind and do it. And I was fine, but
don't quite know what the effect of that metal on
the face
will be
Okay, so Peter's hair, that I don't know what mine looks like, but I can see his standing up quite
Yours was good.
Yours was really impressive.
Yeah. But yours is doing really well. Yeah.
I can't see it.
I know. Here, I'll show you.
Yeah, it's definitely standing up now.
It's definitely
if your hair was down here before.
Can you see you?
Oh, wow.
It's pretty good.
Here, yeah.
I'll get a Peter.
Oh, wait, as soon as
I've only got one hand on, that's fine.
No, but I feel...
So you can actually take your hand off and put it back
on. Whoa.
Yep.
Whoa! Why is it making that noise?
What, the crackle?
The discharge.
You'll have a different potential between there and there.
Because you've got a different charge build up on there as opposed to your head.
So you can actually, don't do it yet, but you can take your hands off for a little bit and then put it back on for a few seconds. Well, look at that. Watch your hair drop.
You're doing that.
Yeah.
Because the charge is going to you and not to me.
Well, see, I'm now acting like a lightning rod. And I'm stealing charge from you.
I can hear them stealing charge.
God, that feels so weird.
Yeah.
Alright, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to let go of my hands and then I'm going to put them back on in a couple of seconds.
Yeah, just 2-3 seconds. Because your charge should be the same. Right? So the reason you're not getting shocked is because you're the same charge as it. So when you take your hands off, you should stay relatively the same charge because you're insulated from the ground. and that's not going to build up too much more charge. So you'll take it off, put it back on, and you shouldn't get shocked.
Oh, right. That's the whole thing with the electric potential.
Yeah, sure. I understand the theory.
The math works. You just want to hope it's like, you know.
So a year ago, there was a show with Todd Sampson called Life on the Line. And, like, I thought the premise originally was kind of lame. And then, like, genuinely, when he did a bungee jump with a phone book, like, connecting the two elastic wires, I was like, man, this dude gets it. Like, this is actually insane.
Yeah.
It's, like, one thing to know, you know, the theory and the tests of it, and then the other thing is to actually bungee jump with the phone book.
So have a lot of faith in the math, right?
Yeah. All right, so 3, 2, 1.
See, the head does not drop back because you're still on
it. Yeah.
I just sparked across the table.
It will jump into the table, yeah, because that's.
So I get off, I'll discharge, and then we fist bump again to see if there's.
Okay, we'll do it.
All right.
You still got some charge.
I still see plenty of charge.
Yeah, hit the table, you'll stop a bit. Yep.
Oh, so good! Physics, am I right?
Good science, guys.
Good science.
Now, I'm not sure if that was the spark or that was the actual light.
Yeah, I'm going.
That was perfectly timed with the spark.
Did we not turn the lights off?
No. That was absolutely not timed.
Sometimes it takes out electrical stuff. Like, we know we've done too much when that clock up the back just goes into gibberish. And the lecture slides, well, if these were down, these would go back up into the roof.
You've done too much physics when the clock is
Yeah, the clock's like, I'm out, it's cool, it's been real, we're done here.
So, we've decided the crypt physics for the day.
Yes.
Okay, so we were rummaging in this cupboard looking for some more experiments to use. And Peter pointed out this strangely melted piece of metal. And he told me that this is a lightning rod.
Yeah, it's a lightning rod that actually was at the University of Sydney, and it was hit by lightning, and then all the current around it basically created a strong magnetic field that basically pulled itself together.
So
it deformed from like a solid, like the pipe that it is, with a hollow opening, as you can see, and like the pipe shut itself and closed itself off. There, pinched itself together. So it's actually called the pinch effect, and there's a demonstration of this here, and we're not doing it because there's one of the transformers is broken and we don't want to blow anything up.
Don't want you to catch fire.
But if you put current into here, it basically does that.
Yeah, and that's what happened in the still beam.
Yeah.
All right, let's go do some more experiments.
Yeah.